I want to go now to the Democratic Congressman John Garamendi of California. He's a member of the House Armed Services Committee, so he was briefed on the Niger ambush today. So, Congressman, let me ask you. Arwood Damon reporting the U.S. soldiers had just one heavy machine gun, no flak gas vests. They were wearing T-shirts. They were wearing baseball caps. None of this came up in your briefing today, is my understanding. What's your reaction to that?
Well, my reaction to that is twofold. First of all, this is a terrible tragedy, the loss of American life and the loss of Nigerian soldiers. It's tragic, and yes, indeed, it is a very dangerous part of the world. We've known that. That's why we're there, along with some 4,000 French soldiers in that area to try to deal with this terrorism. With regard to the briefing, sometimes we're treated like mushrooms. We're kept in the dark, and your report on the ground from Niger is in many ways much more detailed than we received this morning.
Is that frustrating to you? I mean, would you have expected to hear what you just heard from Arwa Damon reporting, you know, what she heard from Nigerians?
Well, here's where our job, we're not on the ground commanders. We're certainly not the colonel or the captain in charge of these particular operations. Our job is to understand what is going on in the region, to make an assessment as to what our goals, what our objectives are in a broad way, and then to put in place the proper policies. For example, do we have an authorization to use force in this area or not? Very big question. But in addition to that, what kind of resources are needed given the task that we have asked these soldiers to do? That's our job. The Pentagon has not been forthcoming.
And has not been forthcoming. I mean, let's just take the issue of body armor, right?
Yes.
I was reporting they had no flak vests on. They had baseball caps and T-shirts. The chairman of the Joint Chiefs was asked whether troops had body armor on Monday. This is a very basic question because most of the American soldiers who were there survived, most of the Nigerians who were there survived, right? So there's a lot of people to say exactly what happened. Here's how he answered that question when he was asked directly.
Sure.
Quick follow-up on whether or not the troops were wearing body armor in the U.S. forces.
Yeah, I don't personally know how the soldiers that day were equipped, if they were wearing body armor.
Do you think the Pentagon does not know this information?
Well, I'm not surprised. I'm really not surprised that the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff is not directly involved in all this. Obviously, the investigations are underway. Your reporter there in the region has access and, frankly, much better access than we do here because all of our information is filtered through the Pentagon, through the studies, which do take 3 to 6 months, and generally, by the time it's completed, we're on to the next crisis. But this is a very serious issue in that the question arises as to what is our mission in this part of Africa. Keep in mind that we're talking about a stretch of Africa that really is longer than the entire breadth of the United States,
yes,
some 4,000 miles, in which these violent extreme organizations operate. So we need to be very, very clear about what is our objective,
yes,
in this area. How are we going to carry that out?
Look, clearly the
sure.
intelligence was off. Clearly the level of protection,
yes,
that they would have been extremely different, right? And that is a tragedy.
No
but
doubt.
I wanted to ask you one other thing, Congressman.
Sure.
What Arwa was learning was that this group was very small, okay? Relative, when the Nigerians go out and patrol this area, they take 80 to 100 men. Okay, just to be clear, the unit that we're talking about here had 12 American troops and 30 Nigerian forces. So you're talking half of the smallest unit size that the Nigerians would take to go in the same area because of how they would assess the risk.
Mm-hmm.
What do you make of that? Where do you think that this mistake was made?
Well, that's going to be determined, but we do know this. We do know that the original mission was in a different location to go after a high-value target. This has been reported over and over again.
Mm-hmm.
When that didn't happen, then it appears as though the mission broke into pieces. One piece came back through this village, and it was clearly smaller than would be normal in the area, and quite obviously and tragically not prepared for the violence that does and has occurred in that area. So yes, there was a serious mistake made somewhere along the line. Was it an intelligence failure, an operational failure, a command failure? That'll all be determined. But what's really important here are the lessons learned going forward. What is it that we, first of all, why are we there? What are we to accomplish? What's it going to take to accomplish that? That's our job here, making sure that the military has the resources it needs to carry out the policies that we and the president are putting in place. Now, clearly there was a mistake made,
yes,
perhaps on the ground, perhaps also in the intelligence gathering mechanisms, and the support that might have been that should have been necessary, would there be any kind of a firefight or incident?
All right. Congressman, I appreciate your time. I think your analogy,
sure,
sometimes, like you're like mushrooms kept in the dark by the Pentagon, a very powerful one. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
And next, new details about what a data company was doing for Donald Trump's campaign. That company reaching out to WikiLeaks for Hillary Clinton's emails. Plus, breaking news this hour, secret documents about the assassination of JFK, some of them not being made public tonight with this big announcement. Why the 11th hour backtracking? And also, the president addressing the opioid epidemic. But what does his announcement actually do?